இந்தியாவிற்கு சுதந்திரம் கிடைத்தது 1947. ஆனால் புதுக்கோட்டை மாவட்டத்தில் வசிக்கின்ற என்னை போல் முஸ்லீம் பெண்களுக்கு சுதந்திரம் கிடைத்தது 1991 அக்டோபர் 2
Most people, Pudukottai is just a name. To some people, the name Pudukottai conjures up an image of a small, backward, dry district. By all counts, Pudukottai is a backward district of Tamil Nadu. With practically no industrialization, the majority of the people are dependent on dryland farming. Out of a population of 13.22 lakhs, 50% are illiterate. The male-female differential in literacy is the highest in the state, with female literacy being only 32%. Today, Pudukottai is a vibrant district, pulsating with confidence, not because of any miraculous economic transformation, but because of a people's movement for literacy, which has generated tremendous enthusiasm among the people.
It all began on July the 23rd, 1991. The Total Literacy Campaign was launched by the Pudukottai Mavatta Arivoli Iyakkam. There was a procession of about 10,000 men and women, with a collector leading the procession and shouting literacy slogans, and with many in the crowd responding. The sleepy district of Pudukottai was slowly being woken up.
களைப்பு உனக்கு நீங்கிவிடும், கணக்கு வழக்கும் புரிந்துவிடும். வலையில் மீன் பிடித்து வாழும் மக்களுக்கு வகையாய் வழங்கும் நண்பா,
வலையில் மீன் பிடித்து வாழும் மக்களுக்கு வகையாய் வழங்கும் நண்பா.
உன் வாழ்வில் ஒளியேற்ற வந்த இயக்கமே அறி ஒளி அணைக்கிது வாவா,
ஒளியேற்ற வந்த இயக்கமே அறி ஒளி அணைக்கிது வாவா.
I can only describe my experience of working with the Total Literacy Campaign in Pudukottai district as being heady. It is fantastic to see the entire district surcharged with enthusiasm and working towards a common goal of making the district fully literate. You may ask, what is so unique about the Total Literacy Campaign, or the Arivoli Iyakkam as it is called in Pudukottai? What is unique, what is fantastic, is the fact that we have some 25,000 volunteers giving freely of their time and effort into making 2,90,000 people literate. In today's world, where everybody believes that everybody else is selfish and that money alone is a great motivator, the Total Literacy Campaign has clearly disproved this. In fact, I can go a step further and say that this program has really restored my faith in humanity. Otherwise, how else can you account for the fact that we've had volunteers from practically every walk of life, from the scheduled castes, from people living below the poverty line, from Gosha Muslim families, women from really conservative and traditional families, and even devil-may-care youngsters. All of them have contributed so freely and generously of their time and effort.
ஊர்தோறும் நல்ல ஒளி விளக்கேற்றுகின்ற தீபங்களே, உங்கள் உழைப்பு என்றும் மண்ணில் உயர்வாக நிலைத்திருக்கும் பாருங்களே.
The campaign is aimed at making 2.9 lakh illiterates in the age group of 9 to 45 years literate within the span of 1 year. Special classes are held for loadmen and municipal scavengers. The timing of the classes is tailored to their convenience.
Special classes are held for children working in the gem cutting industry. Ariwoli takes into its fold tender young working children who never had access to formal schooling. After a hard day's toil, these eager and determined young ones fight back sleep to attend an Ariwoli class.
But I'd like to stress just 3 points. One, that this is a different kind of program, not the conventional department-run Sarkari literacy program. This is a program that involves the government, administration, and the entire people in a massive people's movement. Second, it is a voluntary program. Nobody gets paid for teaching. Nobody gets paid anything extra for working 16, 17 hours a day. Thirdly, it is time-bound. We don't dilly-dally, we don't say 1,000 this year, 2,000 next year. It's all at one go, lakhs, mind-boggling figures. Just 1 year, 3-4 months of preparation, 6 months of teaching, 2-3 months of mopping up, and getting ready for beyond literacy. Ariwoli, or total literacy campaigns, make India that much more of a democracy by invoking and evoking popular participation.
What is again unique about the project is the fact that this program is being implemented with the close cooperation of the government officials on the one hand, a core group of dedicated workers who work full-time on the project, and of course the people. In fact, government officials who were at first a little taken aback at being asked to sing Ariwoli songs and raise Ariwoli slogans have today joined in the fun. And in fact, if you go to any function or to any village, it is our government officials who first go to the mic. Now for our core group of dedicated workers, their commitment, honesty, sincerity, dedication is really heartwarming. They spend sleepless nights with total commitment to the project, to making the district fully literate.
Our Ariwoli day's work starts at 9 a.m. and ends at the next day morning, that is after 12 p.m. We are engaged in the hardest work of our lifetime, but we enjoy it, we love it, and we are happy while doing it.
As for the people of Pudukkottai, they've really excelled themselves. They have shown their solidarity every inch of the way, and they are really working hard to making the district fully literate.
என் பேர் வசந்தா. நான் படிச்சிருக்கேன். அறிவியல் இயக்கத்தில் பாடம் நடத்துறதுக்காக என் வீட்டில் இடம் கொடுத்து நானே பல்ப்பு போட்டு 10 பிள்ளைகளுக்கு சொல்லி கொடுத்துக்கிட்டு இருக்கேன்.
யூனிக் டெடிக்கேட்டட் இன்வால்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் கிராஸ் செக்ஷன் ஆஃப் தி சொசைட்டி ஆஃப் திஸ் டிஸ்ட்ரிக்ட் இஸ் அ ஹோல் ரைட் ஃப்ரம் தி கலெக்டர் ஹூ இஸ் ஹெட் ஆஃப் தி ஹெட் ஆஃப் தி அட்மினிஸ்ட்ரேஷன் ஹியர் டு தி வில்லேஜ் லெவல் ஒர்க்கர் ஆஃப் தி கவர்மெண்ட் ப்ளஸ் டீச்சர்ஸ் கவர்மெண்ட் அஃபீஷியல்ஸ் நான் கவர்மெண்ட் அஃபீஷியல்ஸ் social organizations and politicians, including politicians, they are more involved in this program than wherever I could see in any other part of this country.
இப்போ கற்பிப்போம் என்கிற இலட்சிய நோக்கத்தோடு இன்றைக்கு அறிவொளி இயக்கம் ஆரம்பிக்கப்பட்டு மிகச் சிறப்போடு சீரோடும் செயல்பட்டு வந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறது. கல்லாமையை இல்லாமையாக்குவோம் என்கிற இலட்சிய நோக்கம்தான் அறிவொளி இயக்கத்தினுடைய நோக்கமாகும்.
நேஷனல் லிட்ரஸி மிஷன் அட் டெல்லி ஹஸ் பிரிஸ்கிரைப்ட் 4 காம்போனன்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் லிட்ரஸி, நேம்லி லிட்ரஸி விச் ஹேஸ் டு டூ வித் பேசிக் ரீடிங் அண்ட் ரைட்டிங் ஸ்கில்ஸ். அ நியூ லிட்ரேட் வில் அப்ராக்சிமேட்லி ஹேவ் டு ரீட் அட் அ ஸ்பீட் ஆஃப் 30 வேர்ட்ஸ் பர் மினிட் அண்ட் ரைட் அரவுண்ட் 7 வேர்ட்ஸ் பர் மினிட்.
எழுத படிக்க தெரியாது. எழுத படிக்க தெரிஞ்சதில் முத குழந்தையாக பிறந்தாக்க பிள்ளைய வச்சுக்கிற சொல்லுவா, ஆடு மாடு மேய்க்க சொன்னாங்க.
இப்ப வந்து இந்த அருளி வந்ததால நல்லா எழுத படிக்க படிச்சுக்கிட்டான்.
Numeracy is a second component of the total literacy campaign. A neo-literate must be able to read and write up to 100 and do simple calculations. Functionality, the third component, relates the learning of literacy skills to daily life. Quarry workers and potters, fisherwomen and agriculture laborers have all started opening bank accounts and visiting post offices.
இதை நாங்கள் எங்கே போகிற பஸ்ன்னுட்டு ஒவ்வொருத்தலாம் போய் கேட்குறாப்புல இருக்குது. ஒவ்வொருத்தலையும் ஏமாற்றிப்புறாங்கதான் அந்த பஸ் தானு சொல்லி ஏமாற்றிப்புறாங்க. எங்களுக்கு எதுவுமே தெரியலை, ஏதோ நாங்கள் போய் படிச்சுக்கிறோம்னு சொல்லி நாங்கள் படிக்க போனோம் அறிவொழிக்கு. இப்போ அருந்தாங்கி போகிற பஸ்ஸோ, புதுக்கோட்டை போகிற பஸ்ஸோ, மீன் பஸ்ஸை போகிற பஸ்ஸோ எங்களுக்கு நல்லா தெரிஞ்சுக்கிட்டோம்.
இப்போ படிச்சிருந்தோம்னா இப்போ தபால் எழுத்தலாம், யாரும் எதுவும் தேவையில்லை. தபால் வந்தாலும் படிக்கலாம், வீட்டில் பத்திரம் எதுவும் நமக்கு நிலத்து பிரச்சனை எல்லாம் படிக்கலாம், கொள்ளலாம். பிள்ளைங்களும் நல்லபடியாக படிக்க வைக்கலாம். படிக்காமல் இருக்கிறது தான் இவ்வளோ கஷ்டம். படித்தோம்னா பெண்கள் எதுவும் வேலை பார்க்கலாம். ஆம்பளைங்க ஒருத்தவங்க சம்பாதிச்சு ஒன்றும் செய்ய முடியல.
சோஷியல் அவேர்னஸ், they're being conscious of the conditions of existence and learning to find ways of bettering them.
இப்ப அந்த முதலாளிய வந்து எங்களை அரட்டி விடுத்துனா நாங்க பார்வழி இயக்கத்துல சேர்ந்து நல்லபடியா படிச்சுக்கிட்டு நாங்களாம் மணி எழுதி கொண்ட போஸ்ட் இதுல போலீஸ் ஸ்டேஷன்ல வந்து கொடுத்து தைரியமா வந்துருவோம். கலைக்கு ட்ரெயின் ஏற போய் பார்த்து பேசிடுவோம்.
நாங்கள் அடுத்த கான்ட்ராக்டர்களே சல்லி உடச்சி 5 ரூபா கொடுப்பாங்க, 4 ரூபா கொடுப்பாங்க ஒரு பெட்டிக்கு, அதுதான் வாங்கிட்டு இருந்தோம். இப்போ நாங்கள் சொந்தமாக புதுக்க மாவட்டத்தில் அரசாங்கத்தில் கொடுத்து நாங்கள் சொந்தமாக இப்போ ஆண்களுக்கு 25 ரூபா பெண்களுக்கு 25 ரூபா போட்டு சமமாக சம்பளம் எடுத்துக்கிறோம்.
ஆனால் எதிர்க்கிற ஒரு தைரியம் பெண்கள்கிட்ட இல்லாமல் இருந்தாலும் ஆனால் இப்போ அவங்க எதிர்க்கிற ஒரு தைரியம் வந்திருக்குன்னா அது அறிவொழியினால தான் நிச்சயம் நான் சொல்லுவேன். அறிவொழியில் நான் சேர்ந்த பிற்பாடு அன்றாடம் காலையில் போகிறதும் பொதுமக்களை சந்திக்கிறதும் நைட்டு 11 மணிக்கு வர்றதும் இதனால என்னுடைய குடும்பத்தில் சிக்கல் ஏற்பட்டு என்னுடைய கணவர் என்னை அடித்தப்போ கூட எனக்கு மண்டை உடஞ்சி போச்சு. இருந்தாலும் என்னால் பல பேர் பல பெண்கள் வந்து முன்னேறணும், என்னை போல் அடிமைப்பட்டு அவங்க இருக்கக்கூடாது, இனியும் இருக்கக்கூடாது. இவ்வளோ நாள் இருந்த பெண்கள் இனியும் நிச்சயமாக இருக்கக்கூடாது, அவங்களோட நிலை மேம்படணும்னு சொல்லிட்டு ஒரே காரணத்துக்காக அந்த அடியையும் தாங்கிக்கிட்டு அறிவொளிக்காக இதுநாள் வரையிலும் நான் வேலை செய்கிறேன். அறிவொளி வந்து பெண்களை பொறுத்தவரையிலும் ஒரு வசந்த காலமாகவே நான் நினைக்கிறேன்.
இன் புதுக்கோட்டை டிஸ்ட்ரிக்ட், a fifth component was deliberately added to the NLM's 4 usual components of literacy, namely mobility. While it is well known that 99% of all adult males in rural Tamil Nadu know how to cycle, it is not so well known that 99% of most adult females do not know how to cycle. The scenario is not so different if adolescent boys and girls are considered. Literacy should not only enable a person to read and write, but also engender enough confidence in her to move away from the physical constraints of her village. In Pudukkottai, about 50,000 women have learned to cycle since the start of the campaign. Cycling was learned by learners and teachers alike, creating a new bond of solidarity. The mere fact of physical mobility for thousands of women has spelt liberation from a constricting social order. One of the women who had newly learned cycling described her experience thus: I feel free and independent. The fact that at my age, she was 32, I have learnt a new skill that was hitherto denied to me has generated in me a tremendous confidence.
அது எங்கள் வீட்டில் ஆம்பளை யாரும் இல்லை, நான் தான் விவசாய வேலையெல்லாம் பார்த்துட்ருக்கேன். நான் சைக்கிள் நான் ரொம்ப நல்லா கற்றுருக்கேன். சைக்கிள் கற்றுலேருந்து காயெல்லாம் பசிட்டு போய் கடையிலெலாம் கொண்டு நானே விற்றுட்டு வர்றேன்.
சைக்கிளில் ஒட்ட கற்றுக்கணும் தங்கச்சி, வாழ்க்கை சக்கரத்தை சுற்றி விடு தங்கச்சி. அப்படி சைக்கிளில் ஒட்ட கற்றுக்கணும் தங்கச்சி, வாழ்க்கை சக்கரத்தை சுற்றி விடு தங்கச்சி. இப்போவே சைக்கிள் ஓட்ட கற்றுக்கணும் தங்கச்சி.
At the start of the campaign, an Arivoli song enjoined women to learn cycling. Today we have a sequel where the women confidently sing to the world that they have learned cycling and can perform their everyday chores independently.
இப்போ அறிவொழியில் படிச்சுக்கிட்ட பாடத்தில்
The Pudukkottai Mavatta Ariyoli Iyakkam is very sensitive to women's issues and problems. In most organizations, it is men who hold the top and responsible positions. Women are usually piled at the bottom. In Pudukkottai, we have tried to avoid this bias. We have a lady central coordinator at the district level. 20% of our sub-block coordinators and more than 60% of our master trainers are women. The sub-block coordinators have to visit the 300 centers in the geographical area allotted to them, usually after 7 p.m. And these women have been doing it with a pride and confidence that only Ariyoli, a people's movement, can engender. In order to further increase the participation of women at higher levels, 5-day residential leadership training camps for women have been conducted. About 150 women participated in these camps, and practically all of them seem potential leaders. The total literacy campaign being implemented in 80 districts throughout the country and with a great deal of zeal and enthusiasm in Pudukkottai is a new genre of non-formal literacy programs.
The total literacy campaign starts off with 3 to 4 months of organization building, motivation and mobilization, which creates a powerful literacy-friendly environment. In this phase, the Ariyoli organization is built up literally from scratch. Right from the district level executive committee down to the street level Ariyoli People's Committee, you name it, and we had a committee. Youth committees, women's committees, academic committees, and village committees. There are two kinds of training programs in the total literacy campaign: academic and organizational. The academic training follows a pyramidal structure. At a district level, there is an academic core group of around 15 to 20 persons designated as key resource persons, or KRPs. The KRPs train the resource persons, who in turn train the next level academic personnel, the master trainers. The master trainers in turn train the volunteer instructors. Each volunteer instructor imparts literacy instruction on an average to 10 learners for over 200 hours spread over a period of 6 months. As regards organizational training, the full-time functionaries of the program, the government officials and the volunteers need to be trained in the Ariyoli approach, the campaign approach, people's participation and volunteerism. They need to be trained in communication skills to motivate all sections of the society. A door-to-door survey was done by 20,000 volunteers on September 15th, Anna's birthday. Eager young volunteers with pen and questionnaire in hand visited each house to make a detailed but simple note of the number of people in the family, the educated and the uneducated. If educated, would they be willing to serve as volunteers? If uneducated, they would have to enroll as learners. District, block and village conventions are organized where an awareness is sought to be created for the need to become literate and to motivate large sections of the people to volunteer their services as teachers.
We've had a cycle yatra only of girls. We had about 20 young girls who are taking a tour by cycle of the entire district.
March the 8th, International Women's Day, was appropriately heralded in Pudukkottai with a 1600 strong women's cycle rally. A banner at the start of the rally read, "Women on the move, literally and figuratively." 8 women outriders on scooters and mopeds gave a touch of dash to the even otherwise impressive rally.
Bank loans were arranged for 1,500 lady government officials to purchase cycles. In return, they had to teach the village women to cycle.
இந்தியன் வங்கி இதிலே ஈடுபாடு கொண்டிருப்பதற்கு காரணம் ஒவ்வொரு மாவட்டமும் புதுக்கோட்டை மாவட்டமாக ஆக வேண்டும் என்கிற ஒரு அவாதம்.
A unique method employed by the Total Literacy Campaign for motivating the people is the Kala Jathan. About 250 youngsters, students, unemployed youth, housewives, and government servants are trained in songs, dramas, and skits. The songs and dances are choreographed in local production camps. Dramas are produced with the local people in mind, and after about 20 days of intensive training, about 16 troops, each troop consisting of about 15 people, are ready to take on the challenge of motivating the men and women of Pudukkottai to join the campaign as learners or teachers. The troops are received by local village committees. This is encouraged to promote village solidarity and to engender group consciousness. The Jathas visit almost all the main villages and quite a few hamlets. The message of literacy is thus spread in a delightful way.
We've had other motivation devices. We've had a Pada Yatra where we had young men and women going around their block for about 10 to 15 days, enthusing the villagers to join in the program. I must tell you what happened when we organized the human chain in Pudukkottai town. All the officials and all the people, we had organized ourselves in the street. And I found two Muslim women standing on the street, so I just called them and said, come along, come and join us. So here I was, rather, with one Muslim woman on this side and another Muslim woman on the other side. We were holding hands. And generally I was asking them where they were coming from and what they were doing. And they told me that they were volunteers in the program.
When I later visited the village, I learned that the two Muslim women who had joined in the human chain had in fact not informed their families about their participation. But fortunately or unfortunately, it got splashed in all the newspapers and the secret was out. Today, it is these two Muslim women who have taken on leadership roles in their villages and who are enthusing other women to join the literacy movement.
The media, television, radio and newspapers are also being used effectively to keep the campaign in the consciousness of the people. Oorkudi is the newsletter of the Pudukkottai Mavatta Arivoli Iyakkam. About 40,000 copies are printed and distributed to the officials and volunteers involved in the program. Contributions are received from learners, teachers and officials. The Arivoli office is flooded by hundreds of poems and articles written by the newly flowering talent of Pudukkottai. The newsletter is awaited with great anticipation by the volunteer instructors. Many of them have made it a point to have read aloud sessions with their learners.
About 5,000 audio cassettes with popular made-to-order Arivoli songs were distributed throughout the district to villages and schools, cinema theatres and mic set owners, making the Arivoli songs easily the most widely known and popular songs in the district.
Every event was used to motivate people to the Arivoli cause. Pongal was celebrated as Arivoli Pongal. A Rangoli competition was organized on that day.
Vijayadashmi was observed in Pudukkottai district by undertaking a special drive to enroll all children below 9 years in school. On Children's Day, a pledge was taken by all school-going children that they would ensure that all the children in their village between the ages of 5 and 8 would attend school positively. Arivoli songs are typically melodious and easy tuned. They lend themselves to chorus singing thus ensuring mass participation. Arivoli helps bring out innate talents of people, and the literacy songs composed and sung by these agriculture laborers are an example.
I'm confident that with the kind of people support we have, Pudukkottai will become the first fully literate district in Tamil Nadu. In fact, the government of Tamil Nadu is fully committed to the total literacy campaign. Today we have about 7 districts participating in the campaign, and at the rate we are progressing, it is very likely that Tamil Nadu will become the next fully literate state after Kerala.
Tana tanana kaalam nam kaiyil daane edir kaalam nam kaiyil daane kaalam nam kaiyil daane edir kaalam nam kaiyil daane kaalam nam kaiyil daane
taadaiya taadaiya taiya tarigidittom tarigidittom
taadaiya taadaiya taiya tarigidittom tarigidittom
kaalam nam kaiyil daane
edir kaalam nam kaiyil daane
Since the making of this film, there has been an important development. On the 11th of August 1992, Pudukkottai district was declared the first fully literate district in Tamil Nadu in the age group of 9 to 45 years by His Excellency the Governor of Tamil Nadu, Sri Bhishma Narayan Singh, in the presence of the Minister of Labour Welfare and the Director General of the National Literacy Mission.